Hey guys, Trevor Boone from Emerald City Guitars. For my pick of the day, I chose this 1964 Gibson SG Standard and the 62 Super Amp. So 64 is a particularly good year, very sought after for Gibson. They had a really good neck that year. It's wide, it's not too thin, it's got a little bit of chunk. The 64 335 Clapton made famous. So George Harrison made these guitars famous because it's pretty much all he used on Revolver, which is one of my favorite records ever at least. It has a really great guitar tone. If you didn't know that, go listen to the record because it sounds like a really badass SG. It's got some cool rock and roll history, but besides all that, it's just a year that's always felt so good in my hands and everything looks familiar, really nice finishing, all the hardware and the cool Maestro bridge, great pickups, but I think it really comes down to the neck on these. It was post all the 59, 60 transitions and 62 changed a little bit and obviously later 60s and 70s, very different, but 64, you still have that really good, just awesome average size neck that works in pretty much everyone's palm. So anyways, this is a killer piece that I just got from Brian Ray, one of my favorite dudes ever. And he's totally a shuffle a deck type of dude. So I get really cool stuff from him. This is one of them. He's had this for a little bit and it's just a really badass guitar. It has the whole Beatles connection, so I'm a Beatles freak, so these always spark my interest. All right, 210s, 40 watts. That is the main vibe with the Super Amp. It's 6L6s, compact little brown face amp. If you like the deluxes from the brown face era, I think you'd really, really dig this Super Amp. Again, the 210s, the 40 watts are almost like a vibrola without reverb, and I love these. So two really cool pieces. We got Fender, we got Gibson. Lastly, one thing I want to say about this is 64 is a really cool year to look for just FYI for all you guys, whether it's this or down the road. I think these are the guitars that are going to be going up quite a bit in the next few years. They haven't reached that whole $40,000, $50,000 range yet, but they're so rad and they really fully encompass all that is cool about vintage Gibson. So anyways, I'm going to pass over to Dan Phelps, one of our beloved customers, friends. He's going to plug these in and see how it sounds. You guys, thank you so much for watching once again. That was a 1964 Gibson SG Standard. previously owned by Brian Ray of Paul McCartney and James, and 1962 Fender Super Amp. Thanks, see you next time.